That's my own.
Good evening, REBBL fans. We are back tonight for a rematch, rather, after technical difficulties last night. I am Clown Thulu, and I am here with my co-host, Serge.
Good morning, afternoon, evening, everyone, whatever time it is.
Yeah.
It's fun doing these international global casts.
All right, so... If audio's off at all, let me know in the stream chat. I'll try to keep an eye on that. But first off, we'll do a quick look at both of the teams, just for the people who weren't here for last night's stream. So looking at Filthy Stinkin Elves, we can see it's a great looking pro elf team. We see some Mighty Blow, which I always love to see on pro elf teams. Due to my own play style, we see some strength ups and everything. So for me, with the super thrower as well, I think it's a great looking team. Serge, I know you said you had some stats on these guys, just about how good of a coach Sir Pickles is.
Yeah, so this is Pickles' second season team, and he just came through. He made the jump from Div 5 to Div 2 this season, and he went through. I think he only lost one game all season, which means that he has only lost three games in his REBBL career, which is not bad at all. But yeah, this team has come through in really solid shape. It didn't lose much this season. Like, all season, it lost one Blitzer, so that got cycled like 3 or 4 weeks ago, and got Mighty Blow, not complaining. He copped the Agi Bust on the Strength guy, which was a little bit painful. That happened in the same game, so losing both Blitzers, and he was able to recover from that. And early in the season, he lost a Blodge Catcher, and he's rebuilt a Blodge Catcher. Otherwise, every single other piece has pretty much just picked up a level up this season. He's managed to maintain a full roster as well, with 13 players.
Yeah, exactly. And that's hard to do with a pro elf team. Usually, you're playing with at least some loners, you know, let alone this awesome team that only has, like, one permanent injury on it.
Yeah. So I would say his biggest achievement this season, aside from winning, has been keeping his team alive. Which, like, a bunch of the other Armor 7 teams floating around in Div 2 did not manage that.
Yeah, it's impressive. So yeah, this is a pretty impressive team, pretty impressive coach. Let's go ahead and take a look at Barbecue Gamer here and Barbecue's Pit Crew. So, Chaos Dwarf team here. Pretty much your run-of-the-mill Chaos Dwarf team. Lots of guard, lots of Mighty Blow, some piling on. We see some leveled up Bull Centaurs. Got a really nice agi up, both on a Centaur and on a Hobgoblin, though there is some debate on whether or not this Hobgoblin is bloat or if he's worth it.
So the thing with a Hobgoblin, the bloat isn't the agi dirty player. The agi dodge, sorry. The bloat is the dirty player.
Agreed.
If you think of it that way, it's only 20k a bloat, not...
Exactly.
That's 70k of bloat.
Exactly. And the way I saw it is, like, he got dirty player first, not knowing that this guy was going to emerge to be, you know, a high agility player.
Yeah.
So.
And I can see why you keep it. Just having a ball handling option that's semi-reliable, a dodge that's semi-reliable too. Like, that's as good as this team's gonna get.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, some nice, you know, stand firm. All the Chorfs here look pretty solid. The Bulls are looking pretty solid as well. While it's not it's a pretty average team, I think it's still built pretty solidly.
It's a standard team. I wouldn't say it's an average team. It's like, yeah, average team would have like a blocker that's died and you're rebuilding. Like, just has all eight positionals level 3 plus. And that's a very nice place to be.
Yeah, that's a fair point. That's a fair point. We do see their team value is a little lower than the Elves. But we already know what the inducements are going to be, because since it's a rematch, they said that the inducements need to be the same, which are going to be the two bribes, which hopefully will do better than they did last night when he snaked bribe rolls, both of them, ones right after the other on the same player, right down the drain.
I think it was on the very first foul of the game.
Done.
Send off into... Fail bribe. Send off was quite funny and quite a good result for Pickles, which he will be unlikely to replicate today.
Yeah, if that happens again, that would be crazy.
So Pickles is also streaming the match himself, so I'll just jump over there and see if he's started yet.
Okay.
No. They have not kicked off yet.
Sounds good. We'll go ahead and wait for that one. But yeah, if we talk a little bit about the match last night, it was a very interesting match. A lot of cool things happened. I know it ended right after halftime with the Elves up 2-1 and the Chorfs had received the ball. But I still think it had the possibility of going to overtime and then really going either way.
Yeah, it did. So Pickles managed to... he scored quickly and then managed to turn over and score again. So he was up 2-0 by like turn 5, but then he ran out of rerolls and failed a couple key rolls when trying to defend that 3 turn. So Chorfs were able to get to 2-1. And if they were 2-0 at halftime, I would have called the game.
Yeah.
At 2-1 with the Chorf offensive drive, able to just mow through some Elves, hopefully, and then go into overtime. It was possible.
Yeah, I think there was absolutely a chance that the Chorfs could have scored that drive and it could have went to overtime. But I know that one Elf player, that catcher that's AG5 with Juggernaut and Strip Ball, I mean, he was a menace for the Chorf team.
Yeah, and he will be again today. There is no sure hands on this team. The only thing is that piece doesn't have dodge or leap, so you have to commit rerolls to using it.
That's true.
Just to get it in there.
Yeah, I was talking with T-Self when we were hosting it last night, and we were talking about what would be better to take on that catcher, dodge or leap. And I don't know. That's a really interesting question. Part of me says leap.
I'm not sure, and I've been talking about that question in the recaps for months now. Until then he rolled Agi, because that piece was one of the slower ones to level, just because it wound up not getting fed that much. Just because it's making the sack and then getting fouled off or whatever. It's not the one that's scoring the touchdowns. But yeah, then it rolled Agility, and it's like, oh, I still don't know whether I want dodge or leap.
Yeah, I think without the agility, definitely dodge, but with the agility, I'm kind of leaning towards leap.
All right, they are in-game, and Pickles has won the toss and chosen to defend. They're setting up
okay.
Now.
Okay, there we go. Finally came up. Yeah, we'll see if any of their tactics change tonight based on getting a taste of each other's teams last night.
Yeah, I'd say that the rematch favors the Chorfs, just because the Elves kind of know what the Chorfs are going to do anyway, right? They're going to try to kill your players, and I don't think that's going to change. Whereas there's a couple different things Elf teams can do in trying to defend you, and he's got a little bit of an idea, or does he like to kick short or deep? Is he going to try to push aggressively, or is he just going to passively screen? Like, that's good intel.
Yeah, I agree. Yep, so we see same inducements, but Barbecue Gamer wins fame. I don't remember who won fame last night.
But neither.
But also, last night, all of the kickoff rolls... Actually, yeah, most of the kickoff rolls were, like, brilliant coaching and cheering fans, and I think whichever team has
they
a cheerleader...
Pickles has a cheerleader.
Barbecue Gamer had the fame last night, because the cheerleader kept being the thing that got the Elves the reroll over the Chorfs.
All right.
Hey, thanks for the follow, Ted Rose.
I don't know when he picked up those cheerleader assistant. That might have been just for these playoff games. He went, you know what? I'm the overdog. I may as well try to snake the rerolls. What's 20 more K of inducements?
Yeah, exactly. Hey, Grandview King, glad to see you back for tonight's match. Hopefully it'll get finished tonight. And the internet will hold up.
Yeah, so what happened is his power died to his whole house, and then it just flicked on and off 3 or 4 times over 10-15 minutes, and then it just stopped doing that. And he's like, I have no idea what's happened. And then when the power died, that killed the modem, and then the modem took too long to reboot, and it took him too long to realize that. Before he tried to switch over to his phone, so.
Yeah. That's a shame.
Timed out. So it was only turn 9, so the admins decided to replay the whole game. Imagine if it was closer to the end of the drive, they might have decided, you know what, we're gonna just do an overtime or something. But.
Yeah, it's kind of a hard call when you can't, like, you only have so much control with the Blood Bowl 2 client on what you can do. Those situations.
There wasn't that many hurt Elves. I think there was 3 Kaz out at that point in the game, and there was a sent off player for the Chorfs.
Yep. But... yeah, there was one unskilled Hobgoblin who was sent off for that snaked bribe, and then there were 2 Elf linemen out, and I think the third was a catcher that was out.
Yep.
I think it might have been this guard dodge catcher that was out. It was one of the ones with fewer skills.
Like, dead though. It was just
no. I think he had 2 missed next games and a badly hurt. So it was definitely going in the Elves' favor, I think.
Yeah. Okay. Having just said the Chorfs had the intel about the setup, do we remember? Did he kick short or deep?
He often kicked deep. The Elves often kicked deep.
That makes a lot of sense, actually. You try to get in behind the Chorfs, separate them from the team. You try to force him into a pass play. He forced him into a handoff play with, like, the ball completely exposed if it failed, which is a good position to put Chorfs in.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember he kicked deep, and he was really good at getting just this screen. Like, he had his dwarf line here, ball was back here, and he would get an Elf screen, like, right in the middle. And it was really well played. I know I am usually a pro Elf player, and I definitely learned a thing or two from casting the match last night, especially just in like setups and just certain techniques and everything. So
yeah, like having that one strength 4 piece was so handy to just blitz a hole. Like there was, at one point, it's like, oh yeah, there's Chorfs in there's one Chorf in the way. You can't really put an assist in because there's other Chorfs 1 square over. Strength 4, straight through the middle.
Yep. So I guess if the Chorfs are receiving, I'll go ahead and switch the view to their side. Yeah, I feel like now that each side has a little more idea of what the other side's going to do, they're thinking a lot more about their setups, like, all right, what did you do last night, rather than going for their standard setups.
Yeah, it makes sense. Is this setup wide enough to cover a blitz?
I think
Probably not. Quick snap there.
That helps out.
Yeah. I think I would have preferred maybe having the other bull in the backfield, just so you can cover whichever side the ball goes to.
But yeah,
I think he's setting up to blitz. That like that could come all the way around and blitz the Jugs catcher, which is a good target, rather than the strength ball blitzer at the front.
Yeah, I
and
agree.
You're not making that hit with Mighty Blow or anything, like if you were blitzing with a Jorf, so we'll see.
Yeah, that should be interesting. I'm assuming he's going to try to get the ball in favor of the right side since he's got his bull over there.
Yeah. The peril of a 2K elf team is that you can't protect all the good pieces, so there's the three very nice pieces exposed at the back there, and a dodge wrestle piece on the line of scrimmage.
Yeah. If you're lucky with an elf team, you kind of get to this point where you're like, oh no, I've run out of line fodder, and you have to put pieces on the line of scrimmage that you're like, oh no, please armor 7, just hold up.
Yeah. Yeah, I've got a dark elf team, and it's like, oh, I've got 2 linemen with guard, and 1 with strength. What do I put on the line of scrimmage? Which is, yeah, pretty first world problems.
Agreed.
Kick was not as deep as Pickles would have been aiming for, but it is kind of in range for a failed pickup to be meaningful.
Yeah.
As we survived the first hit.
Survives the second hit.
Piling on could be coming. Doesn't look like it. Doesn't want to leave a hole in the middle.
Yep, he remembers from last night. There we go.
Got one. 1 out of 3 sounds about right from your line of scrimmage blocks.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, I'm betting that he probably kicked aiming somewhere back around here and it just scattered the way he did not want it to scatter.
Yeah. Oop, looks like the Claw Palmer is coming for the strength. It has Dauntless, so it does not need a second assist, which is handy. You don't want to commit too many pieces all the way over there when the elves can come streaming down the left.
Yeah, I agree. He made good use of Dauntless last game for trying to take care of that strength 4. And he took him down a couple times. He just, even with the piling on, he just could not break that armor.
I think he KO'd it, but then Pickle scored. And then he KO'd it again, but then Pickle scored. So it didn't matter.
Yeah, it was something like any time that he actually got a hold of the guy and did something meaningful to him, the drive ended.
Imagine on Pickle's turn, the Mighty Blow is going to be targeting that Hobgoblin on the edge just to get that 2 SVP.
Yep. T-Self and I both wondered if we would see any sort of, like, vanity pass from that guy. Just to get the level up.
Possibly. But I...
It absolutely depends on how the game goes.
Yeah. Like, if the Chorf score on turn 8, you go, you know what, he could be the thrower for the one turn attempt or something. No, actually, no, you have a great throw on the bench. His pro fails, or works and then fails. Rerolling the exact same dice.
Wow.
He can stay on this if he wants to make a hit. Or he can, like, step forward if he wants to maybe try to make a hole through.
Yeah, and it looks like what he's starting to do.
Ugh.
That tells me he's gonna go full offense here and try to make a hole.
There is.
Ooh.
Forward scatter, sideways scatter. Pity none of these elves have a leap. A pretty decent line across the front there. That's tough to break through. I mean, okay, the hole is with the blitzer hitting the chorf and then probably the jugs guy blitzing the stand firm.
Yeah, although I think the blitzer definitely has to take down Korean short ribs because he's got stand firm.
I guess you're trying to get one of the catches down to pick up the ball. Which if you do, you are out of range of all the tackle chores. Like, the only pieces that can hit you just hobgoblins and a bull centaur, which does not have tackle.
Yeah, and that's where he wants to be.
Alright, he might be going for the palm chore in order to make the hole. As we see an armor break there.
Yeah,
he would have to commit the guard catcher if he wants to make this hit.
He will.
Just less than ideal. But that's what guard's for, right?
Yeah, if you've got guard, you're going to be taking some hits at some point.
Yeah, that's a slightly annoying having to do the blitz with the wrestle as well.
Yeah, especially because if he puts the guard here and the wrestle ends up being a both down, then he's blocked his path through.
I think you'd re-roll it if you roll it, if you want to nine it.
It
is that good an opportunity to get down here.
I agree. So he does do that. He does put that in there. He comes in for the blitz. And he gets the pow. Perfect. Definitely follow that. Another
armor break
to an injury. Oh man, just badly hurt.
A really good start. I'd consider apoing it. I mean, the elves aren't going to hurt you that much in theory.
Yeah, I mean, what's he going to do? Apo a hobgoblin? He does use it.
Yep, there it is.
He gets him back. That was worth it.
Oh boy. Yeah, that's really nice for Pickles. And all of a sudden we have four.
Whoop.
Elves that can get down here right on the ball.
Oh yeah, and here they come pouring right through.
I imagine the jugs guy might go for the pickup and then pass it to the blood stepper or something.
Yeah, I could definitely see that. However, the blood stepper is not, I mean, he's The Chaos Dwarfs will have to make a go for it to hit him, but he's not out of range.
Right, unless he does GFIs himself, which you don't really want to do before you're going for the ball.
Yeah, I think it's still a pretty fair spot, because these Dwarfs here are pretty tied up. So, and so is this guy, so he's
only
one open.
Killer?
Yeah.
Killers, yeah. The other option is you could just pick it up and punt it down to the corner and go, I'll beat you to the ball.
Yeah, I saw the one Skaven team do it in the first match of the playoffs that Zord streamed. Mm. It was like Skaven versus Nurgle. Gutterrunner came up, grabbed the ball, and just punted it into the backfield. Like, my Gutterrunners will get there first.
Yeah. And here we go. Go for the ball.
Picks it up, no problem.
Just edgy five things.
Oh yeah.
Makes the pass back to the catcher.
Yeah,
This one is kind of actually screened off. So the Hobgoblin would have to take down Odorous Owen, and that could clear a path to the ball from probably Memphis Ribs. But,
yeah, that's that is rough.
Yeah, this is exactly the start the Profs wanted.
Oh yeah, for sure. They broke right through the line. Honestly, I think it came down to over here with St. Louis Ribs doing that blitz. You know, it almost seems like it might have been easier if he took the both down.
Yeah, I think it would have taken the both down against the sidestepper. You just, why would you give your opponent the choice?
Yeah.
Like, I guess you freed up your killer. You eliminated the return hit on the killer, but was that worth it? I doubt it. Results-based thinking, obviously not.
Yeah, when we see the results, it definitely wasn't worth it. I think at the time, I was kind of leaning towards the both down, but I wasn't entirely partial either way. But seeing these results, it definitely would have helped to take the both down. I'm interested to see what he does to try to get out of this.
There's not much. I mean, you can break tackle, or not break tackle, it's a 1-in-9 dodge to just blitz it with a bull, but needing a pow, or you can break tackle to blitz it with the other bull. Actually, if you blitz it with pulled pork, you can push it into the beef brisket for a follow-up hit.
Oh,
that's also
true.
The case if you manage to blitz it with a chorf. Beef brisket is a follow-up hit, which I think you probably be angling for.
Yeah.
But I can't see how you're really getting the ball safe. I like how Pickles tagged up smoked wings over here, because that does kind of eliminate any sort of handoff play to try to get the ball away.
Yeah, it also eliminates any sort of, like, moving the hobgoblin in to try to mark or get an assist on something.
Yeah, or be a cage corner.
Yeah. Yeah, because even if he does somehow take down Tainted Tom, I don't think his recovery skill or his recovery options are going to be that plentiful.
Yeah, you're going to get hit by William wherever you go. Alright. Will Owen go down?
Ooh, he moves him first.
Why would we put baby back ribs there? We didn't, if we were gonna move St. Louis ribs.
Yeah.
He might have gone, I doubt he has, but he could have gone, you know what, it's too hard to go for the ball, let's just take like mighty blow hits and try to pressure a score so I can try to make it 1-1 at the half. But
that's true, if he's, you know, having flashbacks of last night where like he tried as hard as he could at some points to stop them from scoring and they just waltzed right in anyway, it might be like, well, you know what, you can't score later if I just kill all your elves.
Yeah, but if he was doing that, he probably would have blitzed with the killer.
Yeah, that's true.
So what's the plan here? I was thinking baby back ribs could have come around and you could have freed up Memphis ribs in order to be that, so Memphis ribs could blitz the ball, but because baby back ribs moved to be an assist up here, which isn't needed, so you see a KO.
Yep.
Guard being punished for actually using guard. baby back ribs move down here, Memphis ribs made the block. Whoop, break tackle.
Ooh. Oh, he snakes the break tackle. Wow.
Pickles can stall this. He doesn't have to just run it in.
Yeah, he absolutely can. Especially now that he's got plenty of time to run to that corner and mark other pieces with his L's. He's in a really good spot.
Blow hit.
People underestimate. Prelves can be quite bloodthirsty when they want to.
So the sideline is safe, can't be reached by anything including the bull centaur. But obviously the centaur could pin you there, so you want to be aware of that.
Yep.
Push on the bull centaur would shove it out of range. So I imagine looking to blitz that.
I'm assuming that's probably what he'd go for.
Or block that. He maybe blitz the killer.
Yeah.
The Agi Hobgoblin. There's you can blitz whatever you want in this situation.
Yeah, his strength 4 blitzer over here kind of has free rein to go where he wants.
Yeah, if the strength 4 frenzy blitzes down the killer, then Owen can just do a 2 plus dodge so you can make a 2 die on the bull centaur, shove that out of range.
Yep, and then he's safe for another turn.
Hobgoblin up here, trying to leveling level rank Reginald.
Yep, here comes the blitz. See it from the corner to shove him off this way. Just a push, but that does open up. I always forget that guy has frenzy, but we just see pushes again.
It's pretty nice having that strength four frenzy.
However, that frenzy just trapped him next to the killer.
He can't dodge away though, because it is at G3.
Yeah.
He's going to get punished for that, but I think you'd be quite happy with this turn of events, even if you do cop him from hit on your strength 4.
Yeah, I agree. We'll see how St. Louis Ribs chance at revenge turns out.
Imagine Noxious Nigel try to screen off the bull. Maybe Matt's gonna try to mark up the bull, try to keep it back. Because the bulls are the threat stopping you from scoring. The chorps are gonna take 2 or 3 turns just to get in range.
Yeah.
Gotta keep an eye on the hobgoblins and the bulls. And the hobgoblins don't really matter that much. They don't have any skills of note.
Yeah, if they get the chance, they're great for fouling, but aside from that.
Well, he has those 2 bribes and he hasn't had a chance to use them yet. So I think I would probably just be punching down Future Pritchard, then blitzing down Noxious Nigel, so you can get a big gang foul on whichever one of those 2 is still on the field. But nope, we're running our free hobgoblin away. Unless we want to use our dirty player.
There, he is trying to at least get close enough to put a little bit of pressure on Tainted Tom so he can't just easily score or easily stall next turn. But
Bull does need a GFI in order to reach the sideline. So, as of right now, only the Hobgoblin can cover the sideline. Although we're probably going to see a 2 plus dodge by Pulled Pork to try to stop that.
Yep. And hopefully he won't snake it this time.
But I mean, like, Pickles has all sorts of options. He could swing back and, like, cage in the middle with all the players he has free if he wants. Or you might just go bugger it. I'll just score. See if I can steal again.
Yeah, that's true.
I would like to see him try to stall this out, though.
Yeah, last game, he didn't do a lot of stalling at all. I mean, he scored, like, really early on.
That's really frustrating. Dauntless not working. BBQ Gamer is down to only 1 reroll as well.
He is.
So he has not blitzed yet either. I'm really surprised that one of these Mighty Blow chorfs didn't blitz.
I wonder if he's gonna blitz with Pulled Pork rather than try for the dodge.
Yeah, but you're giving up the Mighty Blow blitz. Like, you could have Mighty Blow blitz Matt with one of the chorfs if that was your blitz target, right?
Yeah, I agree. This guy could have Korean Short Ribs. Well, if you had an extra assist, Korean Short Ribs could have done it. Nope, he is doing it with the bull. He wants to take down.
And he's blitzing the blodger with no tackle.
He's pow fishing for that one. Did not pay off.
I think Pickles would be pretty happy with that result.
Now, yes. He did not use the break tackle for his first dodge. But with only 1 more square of movement, I don't know if you...
The value of getting off this piece is that then it's not possible for Pickles to take down both bull centaurs in the same turn. because if they both go down, that makes the stall that much easier. Again, the bull centers are the only real threat.
Oh, but they have the star hobgoblin right here. He's going to single-handedly murder Tainted Tom.
As long as the ref doesn't hate him.
Yeah. Yeah, I think as Troxbirds put it last night, the ref was vegan. So, barbecue's pit crew. Was not lucky with the choice of ref.
Seen a dodge from the Agi Hobgoblin. That might be the blitz target. Possibly from the Mighty Blow.
I would think, yeah, the Mighty Blow's in range. If he's going to be blitzing baked beans, I feel like he'd come at it with the Mighty Blow.
Or he could just take the safer. I think it's a GFI to hit it. One, two, three. Yeah, it's a GFI to blitz him with the Mighty Blow.
Oh, yeah.
So he can blitz down the bulls. You might just take the block and tackle hit on baked beans rather than Mighty Blow.
Just hope that Armor 7 fails.
Yeah.
Which it's seems
also,
like...
more likely takedown with block and tackle rather than just block.
That's true.
But yeah, like removing that piece makes it that much easier if you do score. Like, and then there's only so many pieces on this team which can handle the ball.
Yeah, I agree. It's kind of the similar strategy to taking out the skinks on a lizard man team.
Yeah.
So he at least marks that guy with the Mighty Blow.
I imagine that's going to be the blitz then, because that mark doesn't really mean anything. It's just a 1 in 36 to give away. I might see the blotch step tackle. Maybe blitz a hobgoblin and mark the bull?
Yeah, one, sure. Two, three.
This kind of looks like he's just going to stall and maybe try to hope Barbecue burns a reroll on one of these dodges.
Yeah.
Trying to hit the ball. And if he does burn the reroll, then I'd be very tempted to just score and go, you know what? I reckon I can get a 2-0 with you having no rerolls.
Yeah, for sure. So the tackle pays off there.
Mighty Blow wouldn't have made a difference.
I wonder where he's going with following that.
He can be the assist for hitting the other bull centaur. Although, he can also dodge Matt to be an assist as well.
So yeah, I guess if he was going there, it didn't matter if he followed up or not. So he comes in for the assist.
Yeah, okay, so if this bull goes down...
Which he does.
We're looking at a 4 plus, 3 plus, then 3 GFIs with sure feet to hit the ball with the bull. Or you can do a 4 plus, 3 plus to one die the ball with a hobgoblin.
Yeah, that's risky. Either option.
I mean, I'd be taking the blitz with the bull. I mean, the only way you win this drive is you like scatter the ball out of bounds, it goes up the other end where you have a free hobgoblin.
Yeah, that's true. He does have the scoring threat sitting down there just in case. But his team is definitely cut with all the chores stuck in front up at the line of scrimmage. And then all these elves back here with the ball.
I don't know if I like that Pickles has left the 4 plus 3 plus here. I think I would have preferred if you did the blitz with Bowie and then Bowie came to mark the bull just so you had tackle on it. And then Owen could have been where Bowie is right now. You'd be the exact same positioning, but just with tackle on the bull.
I agree. I agree with that. That would have maximized skill usage there.
He could also... I don't think I'd risk moving to the sideline, because you could give the Hobgoblin the 4 plus 3 plus surf attempt. So I think you stay where you are. Or maybe come back a couple of squares. Like, he could retreat, like, up the sideline, because there's no, like, path through.
That's true. Oh. Okay, so he...
The bull centaur charge, I think. Unless you just go for a kill attempt.
That's probably what it'll do. There are some options here for some chores to move back to help before the crazy blitz, but I think he's definitely counting on that bull centaur blitz.
Yeah, there's a path downfield. So Pickles has got, like, elves, like, in a big circle around these troughs, but he did leave a slight gap next to the bull centaur. They can run down there. And then mark up bull, put tackle on all these elves.
Yeah, with dodge and sure feed on beef brisket, that's going to be helpful to have those free rerolls.
4 plus, 3 plus, 2 plus, 2 plus, 2 plus to 2 die the ball, needing a pal. That might even be like a 50% play, 40% play or something. It's not that bad.
Yeah.
Considering how important it is, you're like, I've seen worse attempts.
Yeah, so if he uses a team reroll, he's actually, from the probability calculator here, he's got a 56.3% chance if he uses a team reroll somewhere in there.
Yeah, that's pretty good for considering how crucial the roll is and how bad a position he was in.
Yeah, at least that's a chance to get to the elf. That's not with the blitz hit itself taking him down or anything.
Okay, so the blitz hit itself, but needing a power on a 2 die, that's roughly a 1 in 3.
Yeah, so that drops his odds down to 24%.
Oh, he's not going for it. He's just going for the strength 4 and not getting it again. Let's see, pro
where, hey, pro. He finally gets it.
Really does not like this strength 4. It has been causing him trouble for yesterday and today. I'm really surprised he didn't go for the ball. That was like the chance he had. Although I understand targeting strength 4 elves.
Yeah, just wanting to murder that elf, be like, you know what, this drive is kind of lost, let's just hope that they don't have any elves for next drive.
Like, Pickles should be able to stall again though.
Yeah,
like, maybe not in the same way with everything marked. He'll probably just set up some sort of screen. There's enough.
Oh,
the bull again. You can't reroll that.
Yeah, you gotta conserve your rerolls. Ooh, but he does. He makes it this time.
Is this enough to force the score? That's the only way that reroll could be worth it. And if it, even if it does, if you fail the pickup, like, oh boy.
Yeah.
I've managed to protect our Agi Hobgoblin reasonably well there.
Hey Tomo, what was, I missed Zord talking about Bull Centaurs last night. What was he saying?
They succeed every bull handling roll you ever need them. Just, they bail Chorf teams out all the time.
Yeah. I know. I am by far not an experienced Chorf coach. I tried to play them for one short league on a fumble, and like within the first two games, both of my Bull Centaurs died, and I just never gained enough cash to get them back. So I played a Chorf team without Bull Centaurs for the rest of the season, and it was brutal.
That sounds not very fun, no. Alright, is this enough to stop a score? If the Frenzy Beast was around, that would be a very bad positioning, but...
Yeah, without the Frenzy Beast... Yeah, I don't know. It's definitely some pressure, but part of me feels like Sir Pickles could probably force some sort of, like, put some sort of screen in here and stall one more turn.
Yeah, he has enough pieces free that he can blitz Beef Brisket, and then if you blitz down Beef Brisket, you can escape back over to the other side.
Yeah. Very true.
But it would require some dice. Things up. Oh, we want to make a mighty blow hit. Okay, this tells me that we're going to score, which is going to take our punches and then score.
I agree.
Which, considering there's no rerolls, I don't hate. It was not the worst chance of getting straight to 2-0 here, considering that Chorfs are out of rerolls.
That's very true. Even when he scores, Chorfs receiving again. The elves, well, depending on how the KO wake-ups come, the elves still kind of have the advantage.
If he wants to risk it, he can ball carrier blitz and then GFI into the end zone, but no.
Nope, he just goes straight in. Yeah, that went really well for Sir Pickles there.
Yeah, that was a defensive drive, Tomo. There was a 1-9 on the pickup, and because Barbecue Gamer had blitzed the sidestepper, which was set up here, the strength four stepped into the line of scrimmage, punched down one chorf, blitzed down another chorf, there's a hole, and then all of a sudden four elves come flooding through, pick up the ball, pass the ball, and then just run down.
Yeah, so we see all three elves stay KO'd, but he had two players on the bench, so he's only down one player for this.
It's not the end of the world, you get another chance at him. But the strength four staying out and the guard staying out means you lose a lot of your ability to try to pick your hole that you want to target. Now you're pretty much reduced to blitzing the edge.
Yeah, I think those KOs staying out probably mean that Sir Pickles probably won't get another score, but I think it's definitely capable of him screening and just stopping the Chorfs from scoring and ending the half 1-0.
He has three rerolls as well, so he probably won't be in the situation where he's being forced to do like a 1-6 dodge to complete the screen.
Yeah.
Like he was yesterday. But we get our Pom Chorf back, who will be trying to make amends for his poor showing. As the Chorf Apo has been used to bring Beef Ribs back to life after a random Kaz.
Yeah. That's the thing I've found with playing as Pro Elves. They just kind of, you take hits whenever you have the chance, and a lot of times, more often than not, I feel like you get lucky with the dice and you get an injury. You just got to make sure that you don't do what I did this season and really be like, wow, my elves are causing some damage. I'm going to just hit all the time with them.
Roll.
Yeah, you just base everything up and you hit a bunch and then you only get one injury or cause one casualty, and then the other team comes back and just removes your entire team. Ooh, that's big.
That's on the weak side as well, where you can target down the Hobgoblin to get through. You don't have to target down the Bull Centaur.
Yeah. I might eat my words about the elves not scoring again this half.
So I imagine the maybe the thrower is the assist here, and then you blitz it down with the tackle catcher.
Yeah. Yep.
The only thing is he can't get as many pieces downfield as he would like. Just because two of his faster pieces stayed out.
I imagine with his rerolls, he's going to do some go for it.
Oh, yeah. If you can get to there, all of a sudden there's no tackle that can reach you.
Does not snake it.
Yeah, that's... So there is, five innate scatters mean that you're blodge step on the ball. With a chance you catch the ball and... Oh, God.
Hoo-hoo. Yeah, Barbecue Gamer really needs to scatter to come back here away from Bowie.
Ideally, like, they're diagonally down so the bull can just get it, then, like, hand off to the Hobgoblin and you bugger off up the right or something. Or the other way around, Hobgoblin gets it, hands off to the bull.
Yeah.
But you have no rerolls. You're looking at a 2+, 3+, right in front of these elves, at best. Like, best case. It's not good.
Yeah, and that blodge stepper being just out of that tackle. A blitz.
A hobgoblin marked over on the left as well.
Yeah. We'll see. So it looks like he is keeping some safeties back. He's up 1-0. He's not going to commit his entire team to this.
Ooh.
So with that successful dodge, he'll probably cut this corner again.
And makes it.
Yep.
So that's kind of shielding the ball off a bit. He can still get there. Oop, he gets that good scatter.
Nice.
But he still can't afford a failed pickup here. So there's three catches in his backfield.
So he'll probably move some pieces back. I'm wondering, will
he blitz down Tainted Tom, right?
Yeah, that would probably be the blitz target to get over there. Now the question is, does he come back with baked beans, pick it up, and hand it off to Beef Brisket so that he can get a higher strength piece down the line? Or does he pick it up with Beef Brisket and hand it off to Baked Beans so he can get farther down the field?
I think you want Beef Brisket to get the ball. Just, it's more, it's harder to sack. It's more moat.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think you blitz down Tainted Tom, get the ball to Beef Brisket, and you cage up roughly where Tainted Tom is, and you can consider fouling him too if you can make a dodge with your Hobgoblin at the end of the turn.
It's very true, and he's a nice foul target.
Yes. So, Barbecue Pit Crew have two bribes, and they have yet to even attempt a foul. Like, that's not a good place to be.
Yeah, they've just been under so much pressure from these elves, they haven't had a chance to even try. They've been, backstepping this entire half just from the defensive pressure.
The bull coming back there says to me we might be trying to cage way back here rather than get upfield with a handoff play. Actually, if your dwarfs come back, you might be able to get most of the cage here.
Yeah. And as we saw last game, just because there's only, three turns left, does not mean his bull centaurs can't get up the field and score.
No, the thing that's different about this drive compared to yesterday, though, is that Pickles has rerolls and Barbecue Gamer doesn't. Yesterday it was reversed.
Yeah, that's true.
Alright, we have a free chorf. Can't quite reach any of the other elves in the backfield. Yeah, so I imagine that's going to be part of our cage screen thing.
Yeah. Yeah, super base. He's afraid of fouling at all because he'll just snake the bribes again.
Oh, that's just... That has maximum value on those on that foul for Pickles then. If he scared him so much from fouling that the replay, like two games worth of no fouling from one fouled bribe or one fouled foul, that's really good for the Elves. Alright, so if you go with a ball center pickup, you can get the ball reasonably far forward with your sure feet GFIs, and you can make a cage like right in the middle next to Kansas City Ribs. But if you go for it with Baked Beans, which is a safer pickup, only a 2+, you can't get back down the field into a proper cage.
Yeah. Toast Guy, the score when the power failed yesterday, it was, I think it was like turn 9 or 10, and it was 2-1. The Elves were winning, and the Chores had received the ball. They were right around here with kind of in a cage.
Yeah,
it was a bit of a loose cage, though. They had two Chores up here and two Chores back here, so there were two open spaces, and where was he? William, the Agi 5, strip ball, wrestle, juggernaut, he had essentially a 3+ dodge and to get a 2-die uphill on the ball carrier, which with strip ball and wrestle absolutely could have gotten the Elves the ball back.
Alright, I imagine we're about to see the pickup with the bull, because the bull can get into the... Nope. Okay. Mind that.
Yeah, just in case the bull fails.
Yeah, covering our points of failure.
Ooh, there we go. Just a lineman,
but... He wants revenge.
I think Mephitic Matt had a... I think he had a miss next game in the last match. So.
Yeah, he's just getting it right. Ooh, there's the failed pickup. Two tackled zones, but they can be removed.
Absolutely. See, Tainted Tom's going to be really key in this.
Yeah, Tom's going to be the one trying to pick up and score, probably. Or do you just go bugger it? Will William, because I imagine William's the assist, and then you can scatter the ball, and then Tom can get it and score. Or do you do it the other way around? William will have more dice, but if it's in a tackle zone, he doesn't care because he's our G5.
Yeah.
But Pickles has rerolls for this. This is a pretty not that hard chance to just score. Like, as it is, he has a 1 in 36, 4+, 2+ to score right now without doing anything else.
Yeah, it's not too difficult for the Elves here. I still think you probably take the hit with Bowie against Smoked Wings to try to get at least one tackle zone off the ball. Oh, okay. So there's the blitz.
The good thing about that one is that it you don't risk a push like shielding the ball even further. Like that way a push was good enough that you could just go straight for the ball without needing a knockdown.
Yeah, I agree. And he's got plenty of movement with Bowie that he can still grab the ball.
Yeah, so Bowie can just go for the 3+ pickup.
Grabs it. Should be no problem now. Elves doing elf stuff.
And we're in a very similar situation to yesterday again. Elves up 2-0. Chorf's with 3 turns to score. The only difference is that this is the Chorf defensive or offensive half rather than the defensive half.
Yeah.
So Elves still yet to receive. So I think Pickles is in a really good spot here.
So we see at least one guy wake up here. But it was not the strength 4.
It was the guard.
Yeah. which I think is the middle piece. The lineman was definitely the worst piece to come back, and the blitzer was the best, so. Yeah, it sounds like we got a lot of pro elf coaches in the stream chat. A lot of people rooting for Sir Pickles.
Is Sir Pickles the only pro elves in playoffs?
No, there was what was the other coach name? I know I was talking to T-Self about it. There were at least two coaches that made it to playoffs.
Okay. I'll have to look up Zord's record book and see what's the furthest a pro elf team has ever gone. Because I know T-Self hasn't had that much playoff success despite making it there a couple times.
Yeah.
I can't think of any other big pro elf names. Oh, Superbase claims he's in the playoffs.
Nice.
I imagine the another is Pickles, unless you were talking about a third.
Well, I mean, I would be happy to see three pro elf teams.
Round of 16 is the record, so that's winning two games.
Yep.
Alright, we're flipping the side, so I imagine the kick will now go the other way.
Yep, we'll see the kick over here.
I mean, the two of the catches are on the left, so I don't mind that.
Yeah.
They can't make it as far downfield now.
Yeah, I agree. I think that was a good call to switch. So Superbase says there are three pro elf teams in the playoffs, which is great. It's more chances for pro elves to
anything
to win
but
the playoffs.
Rats. Yeah. Jellybean jump around the third. I don't know their coach.
Neither do I.
We're thinking a lot about this setup, which has largely been the same for two games now.
Yeah. Although I think just about every time it's ended up with the Pro Elves getting through and grabbing the ball, or at least putting a lot of pressure. So we might be trying to think, all right, how can I change this?
Like, you can pull like the Bull and the Hobgoblins a little bit further back, but if you do, you're probably not going to get the three turn. So you'd almost be considering, do you try to load up one side, because you need to score here. I don't think it's the way you win if you can't score in this half.
Yeah, because otherwise you're kicking off to the Elves and you're down by two touchdowns. That's tough. It's gonna take some real skill and real luck to...
The deep kick. You can't... Perfect defense helps, but he can't really get away from all these mighty blows, so...
Yeah.
Impactful as it could have been.
Last time he got perfect defense, he just kind of kept to the center there, but it looks like now he's changing his setup a little bit.
Because he's going line of scrimmage, hoping to sidestep forwards, minimize those hits.
Oh, that's true. So yeah,
what div is Barbecue Game from? Let me look it up.
I don't know. Yeah, I'd have to check that one.
So Barbecue's pit crew is from 4C over in REL, and this is his second season in REBBL.
Okay. Yeah, I noticed his Blood Bowl 2 coach level was like 17 or something, so I figured this was probably his like first or second season.
Yeah. Whereas Pickles, this is also only his second season, but he's been very, very good in those two seasons.
I feel like he definitely has some either tabletop or like experience on fumble.
He does do a bit of CCL as well, I know. So I don't think REBBL was his first port of call for Blood Bowl. He just found it a little bit later in his coaching career, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, that was same with me. I only discovered it because of the Eurogamer article. Yep. That's when I joined.
Backward scatter.
Just more.
The elves are gonna shove down. Like, their perfect defense set them up to be able to shove downfield, because these chorks cannot really get in front of these two catchers over here.
Yeah, and that backward scatters just more spaces for the chorks to have to move.
So committing these hobgoblins forward means that if the elves get past, they're past. Like, I get that if they're forward, it's a little bit harder to get through, but...
It's still not too hard to get through, though, because he's got this guard catcher over here.
Yeah.
He can easily blitz one of these.
Blitz the edge one, and then you can get the two catches through, yeah.
Yeah.
But I guess if you pull your hobgoblins back, they can't score. Where they are right now, they're still scoring threats.
That's true. That's a shame. Another blitz with the killer and no knockdown.
Pro?
I have a feeling he'll use pro on this one. Didn't work. Yeah.
Kicker is a good piece to target. That piece has been causing all this trouble for you by setting up all these plays.
Yeah. Kick is a fantastic skill for pro elves.
Like, at this point, I might start throwing chore fouls, just because your hobgoblins are, like, needed.
Yeah. But so there we go.
Get a Kaz here.
But it's always the lineman. I mean, that's what it was last game. He can only get the lineman casualty.
Like, if this blitzer stays on his feet as well, you get a mighty blow hit on a hobgoblin.
Ooh. So Memphis Ribs, he's opened to go where he needs to. I wonder if he'll keep him there, is just to stay in the way.
I think you need to fill that gap in the middle, because he piled on. You can't allow that open too, because that will allow these other pieces downfield as well.
Yeah.
Although I don't know how much Pickles should commit downfield, because there's always the chance that they can get the ball to the full center or hobgoblin and just get past you. You don't want to give up all this good progress.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you take them both down there.
Yeah. He's learned his lesson from punching these blisters the first time.
He's learning from his mistakes. That's good. Ah, but it's still...
1-9.
Ooh.
I think Pickles would have been wanting a push there so he could punch the hobgoblin.
Yeah.
But this could still create a hole, but there's probably too much guard on it.
There's still a fair hole towards the center there with Memphis Ribs.
Yeah.
Yeah, super base. When you roll doubles, you can't really justify taking kick if you can get guard on a lineman. But any other chance you get a lineman to level, it's like kick is one of the first skills you want to take on lineman. If you don't have a kicker already. So that's interesting.
Do we make our hole in the middle or at the edge? Because if you make the hole in the middle, I think you can get more pieces down, but you can't really get the catches down.
Yeah.
If you go off the edge, you can get three catches downfield while keeping everything else back as a sweeper.
Yeah, but even if you get the catchers down, I guess you might have enough movement to mark Beef Brisket, but the Hobgoblin's back far enough. I think the middle is where he wants to go.
I don't think the Hobgoblin can, like, get to a cage next turn, though. Well, if it does, the cage will require the other hobgoblins to make, and if they're part of the cage, they're not scoring. So, anyway, we're going for the middle. And with that, we're still pushing through. I thought that push result might mean that we give up on aggressively defending this and just passively screen them off.
Yeah, I think with the two rerolls left, we'll see them try to dodge some pieces through.
Yeah. And wrestle strip's pretty handy against these ball carrying hobgoblin.
Yeah, for some reason I keep thinking that that a beef brisket has sure hands, but he does not. And that's really come to be a problem with William strip ball.
There's two Agi 5 wrestle pieces in the backfield. That's not good. Take the both down, I guess.
Dodge fails, tackle.
Alright, so yep. Forced to use one of our rerolls.
Ooh, he snakes it.
It's unfortunate.
But he's still in a pretty good position even with that.
I mean, he can get scoring threats downfield, like, at the moment. I might have liked to have seen the blitzer dodge back just to really screen off these hobgoblins. And, like, the killer can free up the bull centaur to have, like, a proper free scoring threat. I mean, it's not great, but, you know, bull centaurs pass ball handling rules, as we know. Except for beef brisket, apparently.
He definitely can get some scoring threats, but the more he pushes for those scoring threats, the less he has to defend. The fewer players he has to defend down here. And with, like you said, you know, with two AG5 wrestle, one's a juggernaut strip ball, players sitting here in the backfield, that's dangerous.
Angel, one of them's about to be blitzed, though.
Yeah, that's true. I wonder if we'll see Rank Reginald finally go down with these two chores next to him, or if he'll stay up again.
These blitzers are proving a real nuisance for Barbecue.
Oh, ooh, ho,
skull. Pro?
Oh, pro. Come on, pro. Oh, yes, best result.
Pro saving the day there.
Ooh.
Pile on. You need the removal. I don't think his piece being on his feet helps that much.
Yeah.
Okay, a bull is free. It'll probably get marked up next turn, but...
But he does have break tackle.
Yep. We have a scoring threat. I mean, you're gonna have to pass to it.
And with no rerolls, that's scary.
You might not have to pass. You can maybe, like, beef brisket can probably get in the middle to be some sort of.
Hey, we take down Rank Reginald. Can we get an injury?
I really like that positioning, the sidestep, because that filled. The square the hobgoblin could have dodged through.
Yep.
Right now there's no dodge path down for the hobgoblin to be a scoring threat without having to make a dodge.
Yep. Yeah, and he quickly picked that position, so he definitely thought about that while the chorfs were making moves. He knew that's where he wanted to go. Sir Pickles has been phenomenal with his choice of positioning.
Honestly, the only little thing I could nitpick him on was not having tackle on the bull, but then Barbecue didn't even blitz the ball, so it didn't even matter.
Yeah.
And here we go.
Just a push.
Good piece to target, but only getting pushes. And it can just 2+ its way out of there.
Yeah. I think for block dice, the elves are definitely happy with the results. so far. Lots of pushes on key pieces. The only real, you know, pals and injuries have been on, like, linemen.
Ooh. Okay. The only saving grace here is that Pickles can't score this turn if this fails. But it works. So the ball's going to run up.
Just barely, thanks to that AG. AG3 on his centaur.
I guess you just bought bull potato to the left, yeah? Just like, alright, I dare you to blitz me. Roll those two pluses, and if you fail, I've got a 4+ score.
Yeah. At least this way, I think that was some good positioning there, because William's dodge is no longer a 2+. Oh no, he's got AG5,
no,
so
it is
still,
he's
it
got
is still 5, a 2+.
Yeah. It doesn't matter. Never mind. Right, here we go. Finally getting a foul, and it's a no assist foul. First foul of the game. And
7.
He's fine.
Close, but not enough. Needed one more.
Good target. Alright, so we got a 2+ to make it a 1 die on the ball. Imagine we bring Bowie down to be our scoring threat, because I think Owen will be our recovery.
Yeah.
Or maybe if a thrower is the recovery and if you chuck it to Owen, Owen just buggers off downfield.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you send Tainted Tom over for the assist, you can still get the 1 die on Beef Brisket, which with Wrestle Strip Balls is pretty fair. And then Fetid Frank is a pretty good recovery, passes it to Odorous Owen without much issue.
Ooh. Okay, we've burnt our 1.
Oh, he needs
his change.
Oh no. Does he snake it? I called it too early. He does not snake it.
That runs a 2. With that, I might have considered changing the option, because now we can't mark the scoring threat without safely. Like, after we'd rolled that 1, I might have gone, bugger, I'm just going to mark the scoring threat, and then I'm going to try the dodge with Frank to mark the ball. Because that would have been the safer route of play in terms of minimizing the worst case.
That's true. Although I think he has his eyes on trying to score a third time.
It's hard not to. You just get that. You see that chance, like I could go 5-0 in this playoff game or something, like that's it, on the cards here.
Exactly. And when you're playing an elf team, and like being an elf coach myself, like just the sheer arrogance of like, yeah, I could beat them 5-0 is like always there.
I mean, you're up 2, you're like, I could steal and score here to get to 3, I could quick score to get to 4, and then I've got 6 turns to steal and score again. Like, best case scenario, you could even push for a 6. But
exactly.
It's getting a little bit ahead of ourselves. Oop. We're going to make it 2 die on the ball, not going to recover, we don't need to score this turn. We can score next turn.
It's true.
Ooh, that's a really unfortunate break, because that was our best chance of sacking. But
it
I mean, I guess the Bulls. If Barbecue Gamer's turn finishes without a touchdown, the ball is on the ground. There's nothing else that can happen here.
Yeah.
So. And then your Agi-5 throw, your super thrower, sorry, can pick it up and throw it to whoever. So you don't need that strip ball, actually.
Well, this at least gives Barbecue Gamer a chance here.
Yep, so he needs a 1-9 dodge, and then either another 1-9 dodge, or 3 short feet GFIs, and then a 4+ handoff. This is the type of play where we're like, oh yeah, Bull Centaurs bail people out. Let's see if they do. Is it?
Yeah, I think. I mean,
chain push. Oh, he can.
Yeah, he can definitely.
He can chain push the marks off the bull centaur, actually.
Yeah.
If he fills in the square to the bull centaur's left, then Beef Ribs can blitz it. Fetid Frank, and then you can remove the marks on the bull centaur.
Yeah, I agree. I think that's his best bet. Oh, and it looks like he saw it.
Looks like he spotted it.
That's good.
just don't follow up and pile on. Although it only adds one GFI if you do, just because you come around to the right.
I think just in case, before he tries rolling any dice, he should probably bring baked beans up and mark something.
Make it harder for like these two chorfs on the right, they should be marking up these two pieces in the backfield.
Yeah. The chain push works out, it looks like.
Yep.
Let's see how bad he wants this piling on, though.
I wouldn't be surprised if he takes it.
I think if I was a...
One chorf GFI, that's not that much.
Yeah.
And it was a stun. He'd already used Mighty Blow, though.
Yeah. So he shows some restraint. I definitely couldn't have showed that restraint. I for sure would have been piling that on.
Well, that stun actually as well is was Pickle's best chance of getting the counter or getting the steal and score. So.
Yeah, that's true. He just runs back, keeps him safe.
All right, we got a 4+ to score here.
He is marking the scoring threats. Threat before before doing this.
Don't punch it with the Rookie Hobgoblin, please.
Yeah, that. There's no Mighty Blow. There's no block. There's nothing guaranteed there. You're fishing for a pow. I hope he shows restraint there.
Here we go.
Ah. Nope. We will not see.
Okay, we'll scatter at least.
Yeah. So we won't see it 2-1. That would be pretty neat if we saw a 2-1 going into to halftime and kind of mirror what happened last night, but looks like we will not see it.
Yeah. I think we... You might just see the Mighty Blow go for a SPP on the Blitz here. I don't think there's not a particularly good way to score. You can like try to pick up the ball with one of the catches, sling it to the Nerves of Steel catcher, and then dodge through. But you have no rerolls for any of that other than the catch itself, so.
Yeah.
But he's going to think about it. Like, is there a way you can Blitz down the Hobgoblin so Tainted Tom can get to the ball? I don't think so.
There's just his pieces are so far away.
Oh, actually, you can. His guard piece can get in there between those three chalk pieces. I guess you have 2 die on burnt ends, and if that's a knockdown, Tainted Tom's probably your best recovery piece.
Yeah.
So that could allow him to get through.
That's true.
Pick up, I thought. Dodge away.
Yeah, I thought one of these dwarves here had guard, but they don't. So
that's the only two that don't.
Nah, he's just going for it. Ooh, and he pays
for
it. All right, so that's the half. I think at this point, the Chorf coach makes sure that none of his dwarves get any barbecue for halftime, so they're nice and hungry when they go back out on the field.
Catcher stays out.
But he gets his strength 4 blitzer back.
Yeah. I don't think you'd be too upset about that.
Yeah. That's
so it's
that's
10 versus 11 going to the second half. I think you're very happy with that as Elves. I fully expect him to just overload one side, go for a quick score. Go. I'm up 3-0. against Choffs with 7 turns. What are they going to do about it?
Yep. Yeah, I mean, even at that point, like, you could, you know, if you wanted to, you could completely play it safe, because, you know, if they score, yeah, it's like, so what? It's 3-1. They're not going to be able
to score.
Honestly,
yeah, you could literally just hide all your players in the corner and just, like, I'll give you 3 turns to run down and score. I don't even care. And then I'll let you do it again.
Yeah.
Like, I'll just run away from the ball. It just doesn't even matter.
Yeah. Now, of course, any elf coach probably wouldn't do that. If you're going to play elves and you're going to play them well, you have to be arrogant. You have to keep trying to go for that 6-0 win.
I fully expect him to try to level rank Reginald, though. Like, this is... We're talking about, does he find a chance to vanity pass? Yeah, he's got a chance to vanity pass. Or give it the touchdown.
Oh, yeah.
Is any other piece close to level?
5
SPP on the guard catcher. That one could be a couple of vanity passes in the touchdown.
Yeah. I think
nice
for sure, though.
Pro elves is they've got catch for all these vanity passes.
Yeah, I think for sure, though. Like, rank Reginald has gotta get the vanity pass in.
Yeah, it's just so important to get a mighty blow tackle piece in playoffs.
Was accidental or not. Oh, there we go. So at least he saved the setup, it looks like.
Yeah, and I fully expect him to try to go 3-0. Question is if he then tries to actively defend or run away to him. I like defending out wide in this case, because if the elves are in the middle, you can collapse upon them. If they get out, if you leave the sidelines open, they can probably get safe enough to run it in. It's a little bit harder to have a safe cage in the middle of everything.
Yeah, you definitely... I mean, good positioning is gonna lead to the scores and everything. I guess I don't mean arrogance in a negative term towards Sir Pickles. I mean it in a more of a fluff term for elves. Like you don't just hang back and just be like, yeah, I'm up a few touchdowns, I'm gonna play it safe. Like you go for that, the touchdowns. You keep playing for the ball.
This guard chuff is proving a little bit annoying for him here, I think. He's like, oh, I want to make these blocks, but this damn guard chuff. But I guess the frenzy piece just deals with it. I kick. Just give him to the thrower. Not doing anything funky with the guard catcher yet.
Huh.
I understand the Mighty Blow Cat Blitzer is just wants to punch the Hobgoblin. Like, you may as well try to level on a Kaz instead of the pass.
Yeah.
Mighty Blow getting him the stun.
There we go, Frenzy gets him the takedown.
So the thing about this setup is he's set up with the Clawpalm Chorf in the safest spot, but it's also in the spot furthest away from being able to actually blitz anything.
Yeah, that is true. Though, he still has beef ribs up there.
Piece.
Yeah, he could hit
Of all the pieces available, that's like the least important piece in the field, other than the wrestle lineman.
Yeah, but I think, I mean, claw doesn't matter unless you're hitting the blitzers. It doesn't matter as much. So, the mighty blow piling on beef ribs is almost as good as St. Louis ribs when it comes to killing things.
One has pro, I guess, is the difference.
Yeah. Like, yeah, St. Louis ribs is for sure better, but I think against an elf team, the gap between him and beef ribs closes.
Yeah. Alright, we have sent the Agi 5 downfield, and the thing about this is that he can only be double GFI blitz by a Chorf. Or single GFI blitz by the two front ones.
Yep.
Is it worth GFIing him to get him out of Chorf blitzing range?
I think it depends on how quickly he wants to score.
These pieces going downfield says he wants to.
Yep. Yeah, if he's going to bring down more catchers, then I can see why he wouldn't GFI. If he was just going to send him down there to be a threat, then it's not really worth GFIing. Or then it would be worth GFIing. So that protects him. Now he doesn't have dodge, so blitzing him with one of the bull centaurs, well, with beef brisket, might be reasonable.
He does have wrestle, so yeah, he has a reasonable chance of going to the ground. Well, like a very high chance of going to the ground. Even if it is through wrestle.
Yeah.
So I imagine the scoring play would be handoff to the Mighty Blow Blitzer, who then passes to whichever scoring threat we want. And that gets us our level.
Yeah. I think that'd be the most effective way to do it and get the most SPP out of it.
Is there a way for the Chorfs back in the game here? I mean,
looking at it, I think maybe if either the handoff or the pass snakes for the elves next turn, the Chorfs might be able to capitalize on that. But otherwise,
yeah, it's really tough to stop a pro elf two turn.
Yeah, that is one thing they're really good at.
God, this game's pretty slow. We're like an hour and a half into it, and it's turn 9.
Yeah, last night's match went a little faster. Yeah, I think. I mean, Barbecue Gamer, he's made it to playoffs, and he was in one of the lower divs, so I think that he had to take first, right, to get that playoff ticket.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, so he might be coming from a div where he just, you know, he destroyed and he did so well, and now he's facing Sir Pickles, and he's having a really tough time. So like after his experience last night, he's like, I really gotta stop and think things through.
Yeah. I don't blame him at all. It's when you're in these situations, like the elves are just putting their foot to the throat. It's just not the game plan you're used to. Down in Div 4 as well, you're just not used to facing a 2k elf team. It's a very different beast.
Yes.
marking up the score, the scoring threats, it's all well and good, but they all have Nerve of Steel catch, so...
That's the great thing about Pro Elf teams.
It's not enough.
You can mark them up all you want, but it's not going to hurt them for the catch. So I'm wondering, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, he could put someone on the other side of Bowie, whether it's the Centaur or his AG4 Hobgoblin. I'm thinking probably his AG4.
Probably worth it, just trying to force him to roll that 3+2+ from tackle.
Yeah.
Like, that would take him out of the scoring threat. You don't really want to blitz him because he's sidestep.
Yeah.
On the other two.
Yeah, I agree. I think, move someone so that Bowie's kind of pinned in between two.
And use then... beef ribs to blitz down probably Acridandy because that one's not a GFI. And then that only really leaves William. But you can't really stop William because he's at G5. But he has no dodge, so.
That's true.
Don't worry about tackle.
So with pulled pork coming in to mark Owen. I feel like you've got to send baked beans around.
Yeah.
To kind of sandwich in Bowie there.
But, like, the thing about, like, all this defending so far back is people who can always just go, you know what? All right, I'll just hold the ball back here. I'm quite happy to watch terms wash off the clock because you are not pressuring the ball.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like you needed to at least send one ball centaur down to threat, right? Nope, we're going for... Oh, that's awful. He's just burning a reroll here. It sucks as well.
Exactly. Ooh, but he takes him down. I feel like he might. I don't know. If he does pile this on, then that gives Andy a better shot. Hey, doesn't have to. Nice.
Pickles will let that slide. You don't need it. He's safe for the game.
Yeah. If the score was closer, it might be worth it, but yeah.
Yeah, bridge rerolls have been really, really good this playoffs. I don't know if that counts as a spoiler, but I have seen at least 4 greed rerolls into Kaz or death.
Yeah.
So far. Alright, so Acridandy and Bowie. I imagine Bowie's about to get... Oh, that's not how I would have marked that piece. That doesn't matter.
Yeah, he had enough movement to get to sandwich him in, like, no problem. He didn't have to make a go for it or anything.
Right, so it's not that hard to... So imagine if you knock down Kansas City Ribs, you can get all the way down to make a quick pass range with Rank Reginald, and then it's just avoiding the intercept.
Yeah.
Well, getting lucky. But even if you get intercepted by a Chorf, I don't think that really matters.
Yeah, that's just kind of a roadblock. It's not like the end of the world.
The other option is you can just do the pass with Frank, who has save throw, but that wouldn't level your Mighty Blow piece.
Exactly. It's like, what does he value more, going 3-0 right now or getting that level?
Yeah. Like, he could just go, he could blitz with the Mighty Blow piece. I was going to say that Hobgoblin he just punched. Yeah, Tomo, I agree. Throwing straight to the catcher is the safest, but that doesn't level your blitzer. That's the consideration.
Ooh.
Oh, man.
Brutal.
Just a badly hurt, but that's a really handy removal. Or would be really handy if this game wasn't over.
Yeah.
You might even start fouling Hobgoblins, just hoping your players get sent off. Well, that's probably more likely that they get removed, though. Or you get hurt if you start going down numbers.
Yeah, I wonder what the blitz will be, if there will be a blitz.
I guess if the wrestle's going to come in on the guard Shorth, that removes the intercept threat.
Yeah, it does. It would also remove tackle.
No.
And push won't. Yeah, but yeah.
Hey. So pass from. I don't think it removed the intercept threat.
No, there's definitely going to be an intercept threat, but it's still going to be a six up, and
yeah, a knockdown would have removed the threat, but it didn't. But yeah, safe throw. This is why we built him as like a pure passer. I didn't even go to sure hands.
Yeah, exactly. Huh. So
he's just gonna pass across. Oop.
There we go.
Yep.
Yeah, it looks like he got a one that.
Oop, there's another one. Couple ones in that sequence.
Yeah. Definitely reroll that. Yeah, and he makes it.
Running full movement across the pitch.
Yep.
And yep. Will that lazy ass catcher get back up?
He does. Yeah, that secures the win for sure.
Still 10 players against 11, but there is now one less Chorf. Actually, there's an argument that you could consider. Last drive, was he better off benching a Chorf for a Hobgoblin just to have a little bit more movement and potential scoring threats?
Yeah, I could see.
Actually, particularly on his three-turn attempt, actually, at the end of the half.
Yeah. I can see the benefit in having more movement there, but there's also a benefit in having the Mighty Blow Chorf on the field to clear elves out of the way.
Yeah, but you're only making, at best, you're only making four hits with Chorfs. You have six of them.
Yeah, that's fair.
Although that assumes he gets knockdowns, and he hasn't been getting knockdowns all the time.
No, he is not.
Yeah. There's a really good thrower. And it's really frustrating to play against a piece like that.
Yeah, I know having the ability to just keep your thrower in the backfield.
Throw it all piece, doesn't matter how well marked up it is.
Exactly. And like, not having to have players back to protect your thrower because he can just pretty much bomb it from anywhere on the field is super beneficial, because that just gets you more scoring threats. And then the other team's like, well, do I bother going to the thrower when he's just going to pass it anyway, or do I go all
pretty
out
much
on
the only team which could like combat that is Kislev, with very long legs and to cancel safe throw.
Yeah, that's true.
But yeah, it's not good to play against. It's, I think a pro elf 2-turn is just about the most reliable 2-turn in the game from a developed pro elf team.
Yeah.
And there's no reason not to 2-turn. In this position.
Yeah. There we go. Squig sandwich kiosk coming into play there.
Kicker once again doing a really good, good targeting those rear corners.
I mean, against a Chorf team, I feel like that's your best bet.
Because Mighty Blow Blitzer that's been refusing the level has been thrown on the line of scrimmage as punishment.
Yeah, he's got Mighty Blow, so you kind of think, like, oh, you know, maybe he'll, like, he'll be more likely to get that level, but then you just, you hit pieces constantly and all you get are KOs.
Yeah. I mean, woe is me, I'm only getting KOs, but... Pickles has also made it this far without using his Apo. He's still got 7 more turns to survive, but what have we lost so far?
Yeah, it's really...
Battery hit on our catcher. MNG on a rookie lineman, and final rookie lineman is just a badly hurt. Yeah, he's in really good shape. And this Blitzer again, eating 2 1-9s.
Yeah.
Wow.
He is absolutely fine. Like
Pro has definitely been sub 50% this game, and the fact that he's needed to Pro so often just shows how poor his dice has been.
Yeah, he's used Pro almost every time. So there we see the knockdown. Will we see the armor break?
I like that he steps back to avoid any like potential gank foul. Which, like, honestly, you should be if you're not fouling every turn, something's wrong. Even if it's a no assist foul. You got 2 bribes and you fouled once this game.
Yeah, so the first game his bribes were useless because he snaked him. This one, I mean, I think he's fouled once, so.
Yeah, they're useless because he's refusing to foul. All right, so I think we will see a 2, possibly 3 assist foul here on rank Reginald. But I'm looking at a reasonably large hole in the middle that the elves can bore through.
Yeah.
That doesn't change it.
Yeah, that doesn't close it up.
Player gonna come through.
I assume that's what he's got a foul with now.
He can do it with smoked wings too over on the side as well.
Yeah, that's true. He could.
All right, that kind of seals the middle up, assuming that Nigel can't clear a hole.
Yeah.
3 assists, dirty player.
Gets the KO, at least. Which, I think that means...
The ref spotted it.
How's the bribes? It worked this time. Yeah, David. That's been a controversial player. But to be honest, he got the dirty player first, and then he gets the agi up, so it's like... Do you refuse that just because it's a dirty player? We were discussing earlier that it's more the dirty player's the bloat, not so much the agility and the dodge.
Yeah. And you can still use it. Like, at this point in the game, if you have 2 bribes, why wouldn't you just foul with the dirty player? Like, risk losing your agi piece.
For sure.
I don't like that he hasn't set up at least some sort of scoring threat this turn. I mean, the only way you win is if you 2-turn, right? Or, like, I know it's the longest of long shots, but, I mean...
Yeah.
If you just put the ball 2 squares further downfield, like, because it's just running away.
Yep, he's like, go ahead.
Yep, this is smart. I like this.
It's like, I'm preserving my team for the next match.
This is actually in blitzing range of the ball center at the moment, all these pieces.
It is.
We are threatening the ball. Sort of. Not really.
Yeah, Draenor, he's effectively stopped the Chorus from one turning.
This setup the Chorus have looks like a one-turn setup. Look at all these players over here.
Yeah, it does.
You have the spot to push it in, you're just going to be chain-pushing a Chorus forward.
Yeah.
Alright, we can't score this turn, we can score next turn. A turn 12 score at best gives you, assume you get a blitz, you probably score on turn 14. Assume you get a blitz and score on turn 16.
Yeah,
that's the best case.
Yeah, I think so.
I'd see a 3 die here on Gassy Gavin.
Yeah, I think he's gonna. He didn't quite make it back to the defense. He didn't quite make it back to the line of the other elves in time. He's trying to run back there, but he just gets chased down by Chorfs. The rest of his team gets to watch as he just gets murdered.
Going for Nigel as another 1-9.
Man.
He was considering re-rolling that because he wants to level this Chorf. It is on 29.
That's true. And one more casualty.
Done.
Yeah, I assume he's going to keep this team for next season. It's in great shape.
Yeah, he hasn't lost anything in this game. Just a badly hurt Chorf. He had a dead Pommer temporarily, but he got better. Well, the Pommer leveled, actually. We didn't note that. Beef ribs.
Yeah.
I think you got 2 cards.
Yep.
I wonder if we'll see a foul over here on the wrestle piece, just because damn you, Pickles, for styling on 3-0.
Yeah, he's got the bribe for it, even.
Alright, the bull, 1, 2, 3, 4, is in scoring range. Pickles, I think I just red die it with the wrestle guy, because if it works, he's out of range. If he doesn't, well, I go to the ground, I'm not getting hit with palm, I'm just getting hit with regular block.
Yeah, exactly. I don't really see the point of sending him back.
That makes no sense to me.
Yeah. We'll probably see, the dirty player on here. KO, that's safe.
KO. Yeah, Pickle's like totally fine with this, and there's another send-off. This ref. He's accepting the bribes this time, but he's demanding them.
Yeah. Oh, did it just... That's weird. Just switched my view, and I did not click switch view.
Yeah, it switched my view as well.
That was weird. And then when I clicked switch view, it kept me on the pro offside. I had to click it twice.
That also happened to me. That was really weird.
Cyanide code is best code.
Now we're gonna blitz. Gets the pow. I guess we are stalling out a possible score next turn a little bit. But we are only risking our agi busted piece. So
yeah, I mean, which is still a nice piece. Oh, he tries to leave anyway.
I still think you uphill the bull. Like, bring over your other pieces to screen the backfield. No.
Yeah, he's going the safe route.
Yeah, which is totally fine. And the hobgoblins aren't really in fouling range next turn. We'll have to foul without Dirty Blur. Staying out of range of these chores.
Yeah. Just staying safe.
Actually, I like having the two players that are upfield together, just because it limits the potential for a really big foul, just because you're going to have counter assists. So even though the Bull Centaur can get a reasonably clear shot to the score, you just blitz down Gassy Gavin, and then there's no dodge required. It's...
Yeah.
It limits the fouls, and you don't give a crap about the touchdown.
Yeah, you goad him into getting that TD. Oh, yeah. Bowie's got sidestep. I got excited there. I was like, there's the Hobgoblin crowd surf on Bowie, but no, he's got sidestep.
Nope. Alright, so we are looking at a 2-die blitz into a 4 or 1 and 36 GFI, 4 plus handoff, and then 3 short feet GFIs to score.
Definitely doable.
And that levels the bull as well, so I would absolutely be doing that.
Oh yeah, for sure.
It's from Sidon. You don't want to risk being wrestled down in your own path.
Oh yeah, hopefully he does that.
I don't know why the killer ran away. He's like, just in case, I don't want him to get blitzed and killed by something randomly.
And maybe he thought he was along the lines of like trying to protect his ball carrier. Like at this point, he's just got like complete fear, like these elves can come out of anywhere.
Yeah, they can.
Some elf.
Like,
just...
I guess if the dodge wrestle guy, he was
out of range.
He'd already blocked it down. Yeah.
Who knows? Elves. Some elf will wake up from being KO'd and jump in from the sideline.
Yeah, like that surprise Ratoga the other day.
Yeah, I heard about that, but I don't know the actual story. What happened with that?
I didn't see it either. I think it was, you know how they did the animation where everyone runs off the pitch at halftime?
Yeah.
They had that, and then a Ratoga ran off too, and they're like, what? Where'd that come from?
That's hilarious.
Alright, Gavin is KO'd. Pickle's like, more than happy with all these KOs.
Yeah, I mean, that just means safe elves. KO'd elves are safe elves.
Two, four, two, two, two. Or is he just gonna cage up? Surely you hand off and score, right?
Yeah, I feel like that's what you do. Ooh, just barely.
Burn.
Sure feet doing another work. One.
There's another one.
Oh wow!
Snaked it.
Out of those four dice,
elves
three of
can
them
get that. I mean,
they could, but
the elves can just run in and get that, and then sling it to Bowie, who just runs downfield, right?
They could.
He could do it. He'd be tempted. I reckon he's tempted. Like he's looking at the AG 5 piece, like, okay, that's a 4 plus pickup and a 2 plus dodge. Well, that's probably a 4 plus pass to Bowie. And then then you just gotta mark up the guard mighty blitz off, and then you can only be blitzed by hobgoblins.
Yeah.
But you're risking pieces, and like, why would you bother risking pieces? Like, you can even blitz some rib tips as well to make it one less tackle zone on the ball. But it's all the GFIs for all this.
Yeah, that's true. It's riskier, but just being able to go 4-0 is just, I don't know, it's more fun.
Yeah.
Like, just staying back here, yeah, it's safer. But where's the fun in it?
The safe play is you just move everyone to the sideline, and then you run your blitzer like into the end zone.
Yeah.
But he's thinking about it. Yeah. So the two catchers can blitz down the hobgoblin, then the AG5 can pick up the ball, which would be a 2+, 2+, then another 2+ to dodge back, and then you pass to Bowie. And then your thrower probably marks the chore.
Yeah.
And then the only thing that can reach you are hobgoblins, which don't have block or tackle.
So, my worry that he hasn't... It doesn't look like he's done anything yet. Is he thinking, or did he disconnect again? Because this is what happened last game. We got to turn 9, we're like, oh, he's really thinking. Oh man, he's got a minute left. He's thinking a little too long.
I'll pull up his stream. He's thinking.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, he's going.
He's moving.
Yeah, looks like he's going for it. I like it.
Me too. I'm glad he goes for it. Yeah, it's not
the
safest
thing. It's
exciting
this way.
Yeah, it's right. Playoffs. You got to entertain the crowd.
Okay. Going for it with the edgy five. All right. 2+2+ to get out of there and pass.
Easy peasy.
He doesn't even need to do it with Bowie. He can, like, take time. But I guess I think you want to get downfield now because the Dwarfs will be able to get back. Just don't fail dice, and then you can win games. It's that easy, guys.
Yep. Run on down.
Oh, man.
Oh, that's... That's
still
so great.
He hasn't managed to level Reginald. Got KO'd.
He did. Yeah, when he got KO'd on the line there, I was like, he's not going to be back in. Wow. Ooh, okay. Yep.
He's gone, no rush. I can take my time.
Yeah, that's true.
I imagine the Chorfs will be able to get across, though. Like, I think your best chance of getting downfield was this turn, and then just go, if he doesn't roll a pal, you're through. But this way, the Bulls will be able to get in range to do stuff next turn.
Yeah, well, with him running back like this, I wonder if he's just bringing the ball back, like, he's not even going to try to score. He's just going to hold it back here in safety.
Yeah. But then why even bother getting it?
I agree. But he hasn't really sent anyone downfield.
He can still get downfield. He has three turns. Like, he's in range. But...
Yeah.
Hobgoblin can pin him right up against the sideline. If he wants.
It's true.
Gets blitz away. Just gets blitz away for its troubles. But...
Though, yeah, to be honest, well, it depends on how much he marks up this middle bit here. But even if somehow he can't blitz away, he's got nerves of steel.
You know what
so
we're
going to
see this turn?
There.
We what? Are going to see a safety chuff. I reckon the killer is going to come right back towards the middle, the backfield. Unless the killer's going to target one of these Chorfs up here. Chorfs, elves.
Yeah, I wonder what the blitz target's going to be. I feel like... does he have any Chorfs that are really close to leveling?
He does.
Oh, yeah, Memphis Ribs. He's all the way over there. But he can't do the blitz this turn, so I...
Yeah.
I wonder if he'll use the killer
the
for the
centaur
blitz.
The bull centaur is also close to leveling, actually. But then you're giving up your chance to hurt things.
Oh, he is doing the blitz with that for the SPP.
He wants to level the bull. Does not get the knockdown. He's got to pull someone into the backfield, surely. Like, the Agi Bull Centaur has to come back.
So something's going to come back. Make sure the elves can't just run back there and be fine.
Oh, God, so many 1-9s on these blitzes.
Yeah, these blitzes are hard to take down. There we go. Even harder to break their
eating
armor.
That first 1-9 block means that we're not going to get tackle on these pieces in the middle.
Unless they send the killer up there.
Yeah, but I was thinking you might be able to get Korean short ribs like around behind them and try to pin them between with the bull center, but can't do that because of that 1-9.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so we're going to have the guard guy off tackle. And I imagine we might be blitzing down. Maybe the hobgoblin, just to get that path down the middle.
Yeah. I think that's what I would do if I were him. See what he does with baked beans. I don't know if will he have a safety.
Oh, if he doesn't, I think you just run down and punt it, and just go. Oh,
he's going. He's going for the foul, I think.
Yeah. Fair enough. Fair enough.
Ooh, could it be worth it?
Gets a guess.
Just badly hurt.
Just barely hurt. Pickle's like, yep, another one safe. I'm fine with that. The Kaz are coming way too late in this game, all these removals. But he's got 3 fouls for 3 removals, I think, this half. So he's showing the value of it.
Yeah.
Even if he has used both bribes.
Yeah, and that one finally wasn't a send-off. Didn't roll doubles yep. there. Yeah, the elves can definitely take out smoked wings and just have a nice path down the field. Though I think to be safe, now even with go for it, you're not going to be completely out of the range of.
You're not going to be safe, which is why I'm thinking punt. Just get the ball like way gone.
Yeah, yeah, that's fair. That would negate the chance to score. Yeah, I think if you brought the guard catcher around, you could definitely get the 2 die.
Yeah, you can punch down either the Chorf or the Hobgoblin, and then the guard can also be marking whichever one you didn't punch.
Yep.
So that it can't get down to stop you. You know what the other punt play is? Give it to the thrower, because he has accurate strong arm and is a better punter.
That's true.
Then you do it like a proper long bomb Hail Mary pass type punt.
Yeah. Yeah, you want to get the ball downfield, give it to the catapult.
The catapult, I like that. But yeah, I imagine you're just gonna blitz your way through. You might be able to get one piece through to screen as well, but that's not. You can get it so you're safe from tackle, and that could be enough. Or you can just hide in the corner and go, I don't care.
Yeah. Okay, interesting. So we see the blitz here.
Rerolls. Okay,
the reroll worked.
Down.
I wonder what he's doing here. Stunning a bull centaur.
Yeah, okay. Rub that shoulder. Yeah, that was a big punch. All right, we're just running back to safety.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, if he's running back to
going
just
down, freed up Tainted Tom as well. So Tainted Tom can now dodge out without having to do a 3+.
Yep. I don't think he has any intentions of trying to score.
He's just like, I stole the ball and I'm hiding in the corner. I don't know why you wouldn't move the ball carrier first instead of doing that one die first.
Yeah, that's true. Unless he was gonna vanity pass?
Yeah. I mean, why wouldn't you vanity pass?
Yeah, I feel like it's worth it. 2+ to a 2+ with a free reroll.
The only thing is you haven't got Tom out to safety yet, because Tom's gonna get 3 died, mighty blow, and then dirty player fouled.
Alright, so he does not go for the
pass.
The vanity pass.
Alright, and he's out of range of all the Chorfs bar the killer this turn, who is facing double GFIs.
Yep.
And I think he's debating which piece he wants to leave exposed, Owen or Tom.
Ooh, okay.
Tom has gone through as a scoring threat.
Yeah. Didn't quite work
Tom's
out.
He's gonna get 7 assists, dirty player fouled here.
Yeah, the game's definitely over. It's just a matter of how many elves can he maim.
Right now, he's only managed to inflict a single M&G on a rookie lineman, so.
Yeah.
Ooh. Like, when you lose like this, you just want to kill something. Just like, give me something, Nuffle, please.
Exactly.
But Pickles still has his Apo, even. Like.
Yeah, I mean, the only... It's all been badly hurt, so it's like, yep, go ahead, stay out. That means you're not going to die. So he's been happy to see these pieces go out this late in the game.
Yeah, none of these were hurt early in the game when it actually mattered. Killer not doing a blitz. The bull centaur will be doing the blitz.
Yeah, though it looks like he can only hit dodge pieces, so like he's fishing for a pow.
Yeah, which is why I thought the killer might do the double GFIs and you reroll it, because who cares at this point?
Yeah, I agree.
Alright, we're gonna have a 4 assist dirty player foul. And then the blitz. And the foul has a higher chance of doing damage than the blitz does. Could surf that hobgoblin. Could he? Push. Well, blitz in.
Maybe with a.
Push. I don't see the surf.
Yeah.
He doesn't have the frenzy piece anymore. Oh, we didn't foul. That's a win in Pickle's eyes, but we did get a 3 die here. We get the power here.
Nice.
How dare you steal the ball from me, Owen?
Still can't break armor. He can roll sevens all day.
Alright, so 2 more turns he needs to stall. I don't think he can... hide in here for 2 turns. He can break through though. He can use his guard piece to get past to knock down Memphis Ribs and then like charge up the sideline with everyone. If you hang in this corner, you're gonna get surfed.
Yeah, I think that's the danger with 2 turns left, and you've got no more places to run unless you try to break through the line.
If you had 1 turn, I think you could have hit in the corner, but you got 2 turns, so I think you have to try to break through. Looks like he disagrees.
Yeah.
I think he's just gonna hide in the corner again. Get really mushed up for his final turn.
Well, even if on his final turn he gets crowd surfed, like he still has his Apo.
Yeah, but it's better if you don't get crowd surfed.
Oh yeah, for sure. Ooh, okay. He sees a way through.
He's taking it 2 other pieces through, along with Tom.
Yeah, I'm surprised. I wonder if it would have been worth it to send Tom up first so you could run.
And then pass to him?
Yeah. I mean, I don't think he could get out of range of the killer, though.
Yeah, we're just going to sideline cage here.
Yeah, because Tom could come over. Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah. Here you go. You can blitz this ball carrier. Can he? I think he can surf it. He has enough players free. He might require some GFIs.
Yeah.
And Tom might have. Tom staying there might take that out.
Ooh. Well, he uses his last reroll here, probably.
Yeah, you don't care. Did the 3+. Could Tom get into range?
I think he could have, but, you know, not anymore. You know, I think if he has enough to do it, go for the crowd surf.
Yeah. Okay, so Lewis Ribs has to be the back. You got enough hobgoblins to fill the other squares, I think.
Yep. But does he see it?
Doesn't.
He hasn't blocked his own path yet.
No. I hope he goes for it.
Me too.
Or is he just not going to? He's like, I want to foul. I mean, if you surf it, you're not as likely to score. Whereas if it stays in bounds, you can pick it up and try to hand off. If it's you surf it, the ball could bugger up down the other end of the pitch.
That's
and
true.
And you would have moved all your hobgoblins to do it. So. Oh. Yeah, this must have been a really frustrating game, particularly the second half, when you're just like, I have to play this out, and it's just really, really annoying sitting here just not being able to do much, knowing
for sure
that everything you do doesn't matter.
And even then, you know, failing it. Like,
yeah,
with when he had the, like, even when Sir Pickles just ran back in the corner, it was like, here, go ahead and score, I'm leaving you alone. Like, he failed the handoff and re-rolled it, failed it again. It's like, really? Come on.
And then Pickles makes all the dice to steal the ball and run it back to the corner just because he can.
Yeah.
Alright, here we go. Oh, this is the one that can level too.
Ooh, yeah. Will he get it? Ooh,
yes,
he does get the level.
So he leveled two chorfs. Another badly hurt.
There we go.
And I think we'll be looking at trying to score on our bull centaur to level that as well.
Yeah. Yeah, pulled pork is primed and ready for it.
I think we pick up the ball with the hobgoblin, and then we foul Tom with the killer.
Yeah, this late in the game, it's totally worth it.
Are we going to pick up the ball with the bull centaur?
I mean, he could, but it seems like added risk. Like, if he fixes it up with the hobgoblin, he doesn't have a chance of entering something.
Or, actually, you could pick up the ball with the Adji hobgoblin next turn.
Yeah, it's true.
No, not fouling. Why wouldn't you foul?
Maybe he's just really focused on not losing this 3-0. And he's just shooting for protecting that ball in case Sir Pickles tries to do something.
Yeah, so we have four, five, six scoring threats, technically.
Five-second turn. He's like, there you go. Go ahead and try.
Well, he exposed the thrower. I probably would have kept the thrower the safest. I think that's the most important of these four pieces.
Yeah, I'm hoping the Chorfs will at least try a blitz before they go for this score.
Yeah.
Try to murder something.
Well, you can use the bull to try to blitz, or you can use the bull to try... Bull can do both. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We'd have to do 3 GFIs to get into the end zone if you're using it to blitz the thrower.
Yeah. But he gets the ball.
Just going to try to level the bull, I think.
Yep, go hand it off. With the reroll, 75% chance. Needs to use the reroll.
Oh, God.
Aw, if he fails this, man.
Oh, boy.
Oh!
Hey!
Oh, wow!
You can still go!
Hey! Nice.
Baby back ribs. All right, now I use the bull to blitz the thrower just because I want to level the bull.
Yeah.
Or you run the bull into the end zone and the Chorf could fail the GFI and give it back to him.
Oh, that's a good point. Yeah.
Now we're just going to score.
So he does score.
Hey.
He does. It's not a shutout.
Oh, he could have hand off again with the Chorf. You're right.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Like, run him in and hand it off. But yeah, it's always nice to get a TD on a Chorf.
Yeah. Okay, we leveled two chorf blockers. It wasn't all bad, but
yeah,
it was rough.
That was.
And the blitzer leveled on the MVP.
Ooh, did not get punished for not doing the vanity pass. Wow.
That went very, very well for Pickles.
Oh yeah, it couldn't have gone much better. You know, just
two chorfs as well. Like,
yeah, just an MNG. And, like, really, the blocks were pretty close to each other, 34 to 29. That's cool. The Pro Elves keeping it close on successful blocks.
And he picked up 21 SBP as well. That's a pretty nice haul. That.
That's awesome. Checking out some of the dice rolls. I mean, at least the block dice. I know the others can be, since you roll for your own armor, can be a little tough to see. But yeah, I mean,
the chests look like they had good dice. Had a lot of powers. Yeah. It's just they also somehow rolled a lot of 1 and 9s.
Well, I noticed
all their powers come together.
Yeah. There were at least like I think there were like 2 times that their pals came in pairs. Like there's a pair. And
Yeah,
there's another pair, and then on the 3 die, he got 2 pals there. So a lot of his pals seem... Yep, and there's another pair. So he had, like, 4 pairs of pals.
Yeah.
Yeah, looking at some of the other dice for the elves, you know, with all that piling on and Mighty Blow, their armor 48%.
Their armor being sub 50% isn't good, but I guess they just... It all broke late. Everything else was just a stun.
Yeah.
It didn't really matter.
Yeah, I agree. They had a lot of KOs and a lot of stuns. It wasn't... Yeah, that wasn't too bad. Oops. What about Barbecue's Pit Crew?
Well, congratulations to Sir Pickles. Pro Elves making it through to the round of 32. This is his first playoff win on his second attempt.
Yeah. So... Now, that's exciting. I'm definitely...
good nick.
Yeah, for sure. I'm excited to see where he ends up this playoffs. I'll definitely be making sure I at least watch his next match. He's a real good pro off player. I'm excited to see him move forward. But yeah, did you have any other closing thoughts?
I don't think so. It's probably worth noting who the matchup is between. I'll just dig that up.
Yeah, true. That's
no
a good idea.
No spoilers, of course.
Yeah.
Alright, so Sir Pickles, where is he in this big ass bracket? He's playing the winner of Kaosu Blue and Random Boy, which is Vampires and Chorfs again.
So. Oh man, to have another matchup against Chorfs, that would be well, if it turns out like this match at all, then I guess he would love it.
Yeah, if these Chorfs are also 1700 TV, but they don't have any piling on. But they do have an Agi 4 Blood Shorehands ball carrier, so that's a little bit better.
Yeah. Well, that should be an interesting match either way. I mean, Chorfs, we might see...
Random Boy.
Yeah, if it's Chorfs, then, you know, he's got practice against them. He's just played 1.5 games against Chorfs before the match. And if it's Vampires, then... Well,
There was 2 vampires in his div this season. I'm pretty sure he beat them both.
Okay, so he's had good practice against them, you know.
Yeah.
Vampires, you know, they seem like a lower tier team, but I don't know. I mean, Hypnogaze can be tricky to deal with.
Yeah, but the thing with vamps is they're best on defense, and when you're playing pro elves, they just 2-turn you, and you only have 1 turn where you can properly try to defend, and if it doesn't work, well, they score, and then you're on offense, and you hate being on offense as vamps.
I do like the vamps defense to a pro elf 2-turn though, because if you run up in hypno gaze, they can't catch before, you know, if they don't activate.
Well, you just throw to the end zone because you have a super thrower.
That's very true. He does have a super thrower. Hey, Swag Veil. Glad to see you join the match. Hopefully you got to see some of that. It was a good match. But,
Is there any other games on at the moment? I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't know. Let me check Twitch here.
Oh, yeah, there's a big gap in the calendar for another 6 hours.
Okay, so no more playoff games. So yeah, I think I'll probably just end it there then.
Yeah.
Well, hey, thanks for co-casting. Thank you everyone who tuned into the stream and saw the conclusion to the cliffhanger last night. But
yeah, thanks for having me. It was good fun.
Yeah. All right. Have a good night, guys.